peace and power.
Amen.
Amen.
啊，哈利路亚！奉主耶稣圣名，我们要继续在这边一起来学习。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we continue our learning.
我们现在要回到我们昨天停止的地方。
We will resume where we left off.
那就是那个我们昨天讲到一个主题，就是那个。十五行传里面的三个统序
，which is the three successions in the Book of Acts。
这个统序是就是教会的基础。
These successions are the foundations of the church。
十五时代这个教会的开始就是以这个三个统序开始。
The church in the apostolic time started because of these three successions.
那这个就是所谓的道统。
The first is the succession of the truth.
那我们很简单的，我们来回想一下，这道统哪里来
？Let us reflect. Where did the truth, the succession of the truth, come from?
其实这个道统在创立世界以前，神已经准备在那里。
This succession of the truth was already prepared before the creation of the world.
约翰福音第一章第一节，太初有道，道与神同在，这个道就在哪里了。
In John chapter 1 verse 1, in the beginning was the word was with God, the word was God.
其实创世以前，神的存在就是道的存在。
So before the creation, the existence of God is the existence of the word.
那这个道就是要成为肉身。
This word became flesh.
但是在道成肉身，具体道成肉身之前呢，神也用这个道来创造。
Before this word became flesh, God used this word to create.
那就是神所讲的话。
Which is the word that was spoken by God.
那个在中文翻译里面有时候会模糊。
Sometimes translations may cause confusion.
那你们有学过 Rhema 哈？
You have learned about Rhema?
你那个道这个词哈，如果我们讲道哈。
So if we look at this word.
那有时候这个道就是讲真理，真道哈。
Sometimes word refers to truth.
那这个就是就是真理
，the truth。
另外一个呢，这个道就是话。
The word can also mean the spoken word。
对，翻译太棒了。那个讲出来的道就是我们的那个 software 叫做 Rhema， 就是这个词。
And the software which is Rhema is referring to the spoken word.
Rhema 是这个是希腊话。
Rhema is Greek.
那我们为什么取这个名字
？And why would we call this software by this name？
本来但这个都是那个谁呀、那个谷子是在做的哈。
Of course, this is all managed by Deacon Koo. Thank God.
我们本来想说要取名叫 Logos
Before we thought of the name Logos.
Logos 也是道嘛
Logos also means word.
但是呢，美国有一个这个是很大的一个那个圣经工具的公司。
However, Logos was already taken by a very large company, a Bible study company.
然后我们用 logos 可能会吃官司，说不定了。但我们不敢，就是。
So we thought perhaps there might be copyright issues regarding the word logos.
那我们想说，好，我们这次我们的主题是宣道。
Well, we thought since this time we are talking about evangelism.
你宣道，这个宣道是怎么样？宣就是讲出去。
And evangelism requires preaching or speaking.
讲出去的道就是 rhema。
Therefore, the spoken word is rhema.
如果你看以弗所书六章十七节，
If we turn to Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17,
我们在这之前就是全副军装嘛跟魔鬼打仗。
In this passage, it talks about the whole armor of God by which we battle Satan.
那在这个当中呢，有5个都是防御的。
Five of these pieces of armor are defensive.
从14节这个真理都当带子就从这里开始，
It starts with girding your waist with truth.
但是第六项就是唯一一个攻击的，就是。第六项就是拿着灵的宝剑，就是神的 rhema。
The sixth item is the sword of the spirit, which is Rhema.
你没有这个的话，其实你就是在挨打的啦，
If you do not have this offensive weapon, then you're just waiting to be attacked.
你真理也是当带子，你绑在身上的，
You're girding your waist with the truth.
公义当护心镜也是保护的。
You also have the breastplate, which protects you.
那平安的福音当做鞋子预备走路，那你自己穿着，你也不能用这个踢人呐。
You also shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace, so you're not using your feet to kick anyone. It's
然后
protecting yourself.
拿着信德当做灭尽那恶者一切的火箭。
Then you have the shield of faith to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one.
你是等着人家来射箭了哈。
You are waiting for someone to shoot an arrow at you.
一般很少你拿着那个藤牌哈，你去攻击，这个不是，这是防御的，都是防御的。
These are all defensive weapons. You would not use a shield to attack anyone.
保护防御完全了哈。
So you are protecting yourself completely.
那第六项，最后一
This,
项是什么呢？
what
拿
is
着
the sixth
圣灵的宝剑，这个宝剑是什么？神的 rhema。
one? The sixth item is the sword of the spirit, which is Rhema,
也就是神的道。
the word of God.
这个要讲出来的。
And this must be spoken.
因为特别讲这个，就是因为我们这次是主题宣道嘛，
I mentioned this because our topic is evangelism.
好，那这个道是从那个主耶稣来的。
This word came from Jesus Christ.
因为主耶稣是那个道成肉身，他是那个道具体的呈现在世上。
Jesus is the word manifested in flesh, so physically in the world.
所以他也是道路、真理、生命。
He is the way, the truth, and the life.
好，那整个的旧约就从它把它转变成为那个救赎的正道。
From the Old Testament, he was the one that transitioned the word into the word of life.
好，那在这之前我们在讲使徒的时候有提过。
We mentioned this when we were talking about apostles.
这12个使徒是非常非常重要的。
These 12 apostles were of utmost importance.
他们是历史的，好像是一个一个传承的，就是转接人物。
They were the historical figures that passed things down.
就是主耶稣的话，他们从一开始到结束。他们都听进去了。
They were the ones who heard the words of the Lord Jesus from beginning to end.
并且这12个使徒，他的条件就是从施洗约翰开始，然后一直到耶稣升天，都要同在的，都跟耶稣有份的。
They had to have followed the Lord Jesus all the way from the beginning, where John the Baptist was baptizing, until the end. So they had to have part with Jesus.
也就是说，他们一直要听啊，
They had to be listening to him the whole time.
并且也同在。
And to be with him.
然后呢，应许的圣灵，五旬节圣灵一来了。
Then when the promised Holy Spirit came on the day of Pentecost,
这也是历史性的哦。
This is also historical.
主耶稣跟他们讲过。
The Lord Jesus told them,
这个保惠师，特别是讲保惠师，在讲这一段的时候是讲保惠师，用保惠师来讲。
In this section, it specifically uses the word counselor.
这个保惠师进到你们里面。
When the counselor comes into you,
就让你进入到各样真理里面。
Then he will guide you, allow you to enter into all truth.
这个就是使徒时代得救的基础。
This is the foundation of salvation during the apostolic time.
这是第一项。
This is the first.
第二项。
Secondly,
这个他要让你回想起，哦，那个主耶稣所讲的话。
The Spirit will allow you to remember the words of the Lord Jesus.
这个我们怎么讲？不是我们可以体验到的。
These are not things that we can experience ourselves.
你得圣灵之后，比如说你祷告，你从小时候所学的道理全部都在头脑里面吗？这个不可能的。
It's、
这个是讲给使徒他们当时的，他这个有历史时代性的。
When the Lord Jesus said that they would remember all things that he has spoken to them, this was specifically for the apostles. When we receive the Holy Spirit, we will not all of a sudden remember all of the teachings that we have learned since kindergarten.
这个是很奇妙的。
This is miraculous.
所以应许圣灵来了。
Therefore, when the Holy Spirit came,
捕鱼的或是当税吏的啊，这些使徒们
，the apostles, whether they be fishermen or tax collectors,
或是革命党的
，or zealots，
好，那这些人呢？他们跟耶稣三年
，they followed the Lord Jesus for 3 years，
不管怎么样了哈，就是听听听。
So their main objective was to listen.
明白不明白是另外一回事，总是听。
Whether they understood or not, that was another matter, but they had to listen.
但是常常是有的是，有时候是听不懂的。
There were certain times when they did not understand what they were listening to.
好，应许圣灵来了。
Then the Holy Spirit came.
他们都想起耶稣的话。
And then they remembered the words of the Lord Jesus.
所以他们每个人头脑就变一个电脑。
Therefore, their brains became computers.
但是也不对，这样讲也不对。
But this is not the right way to say it either.
因为电脑是死的。
Because a computer
没有生命啊。
Does not have life.
那他们有耶稣生命的，有圣灵的这个，并且有所有资讯都出来了哈。
What I'm trying to say is that they had all of the words of the Lord Jesus, the life of the Lord Jesus, all surfaced.
所以他们就讲出得救的道理。
And therefore, they were able to speak the word of salvation.
所以使徒就是耶稣教训的一个，经过应许圣灵的那个，带领。讲出得救要道的开始。
Therefore, we see how the apostles were the starting point of being able to preach the gospel of salvation through the word that they heard and after receiving the promised Holy Spirit.
所以我们知道。
Therefore, we can understand.
使徒时代的那个什么基础哈，那个。圣经所讲的那个根基呀、啊，哈，就是这个根基哈、啊，是使徒。
Therefore, we can understand that the foundation of the apostolic period is the apostles.
然后呢，接下来才 先知。
After the apostles are the prophets.
那保罗只是，其实在使徒时代，一开始呢就有使徒、先知、传福音的牧师、教师，这个是在那个第四章第十二节啊，第十一节。
In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11, it tells us that during that time, they had both apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers.
这些，因为在当时没有新约啊，就是他们讲的话。
At that time, they did not yet have the New Testament, therefore, it was all relying on the words of these people.
以什么为主呢？
And what was their foundation?
就是使徒的教训开始。
It all came from the teachings of the apostles.
这个昨天我们也看过，我们再看一次。
We read this yesterday, but let's review it.
这就是使徒行传第二章。
Acts chapter 2.
41-42节。
Verses 41 and 42.
42节。
42.
在那一天有3000人受洗。
On that day, there were 3,000 who were baptized.
42节。
42.
他们怎么开始过那个那个在主里面的生活呢？
How did they live a life in Christ?
最先是多恒心遵守使徒的教训。
First of all, they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine.
所以使徒的教训是使徒在当时使徒时代教会的开始的根基。
The apostles' teachings were the beginning of the apostolic church.
那使徒的教训，五旬节之后第一个那个第一个使徒的教训有明文规定的是有明文记载的是什么呢
？What is the first recording of the apostles' teaching？
也就是使徒行传第二章第十四节开始的那个彼得的教训。
In Acts chapter 2, verse 14, this is the teaching of Peter.
那就是彼得跟十四节跟十一个使徒他们站起来高声说。
Peter stood up with 11 and raised his voice to say.
当然这里是说彼得和十一个使徒站起来高声说，好像十二个人在讲话一样。
We might think that these are 12 people that are speaking together.
其实当然可能是一个人讲嘛，但是这里告诉我们是十二个同发声，同步发声。
Of course, it was just one person who was speaking, but all 12 were together in unity.
所以这里呢，从开始讲，你就可以看得到应许圣灵降下来，他把整个耶稣的事件，所谓耶稣事件，就耶稣救赎了这整个3年来，到最后钉十字架这个事情呢，整个跟旧约连接起来了。
After receiving the Holy Spirit, he was able to connect the entire life and ministry of the Lord Jesus to the Old Testament.
你看，在他们一想就想到那个约珥书。
The first passage he thought of was in Joel.
耶稣有没有教过他们这个？
Did the Lord Jesus mention this to them before?
在福音书我们没看到。
We don't see this in the Gospels.
这个是圣灵的教导。
This is the teaching of the Holy Spirit.
这就是保惠师的教导。
This is the teaching of the counselor.
那保惠师是谁？
Who is the counselor?
保惠师就是那义者耶稣啊。
The counselor is the righteous one, the Lord Jesus.
好，那讲完之后，我们看第37节。
Let's look at verse 37.
这讲的话就是那个神的宝剑哦，圣灵的宝剑哦。
The words that were spoken were the spirit, the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God.
也就是神的话。
The spoken word of God.
哎，就是 array 嘛。如果你看那个我们的 software 里面，它是写什么样的？神的 array 嘛。
If you look into the original text, it says God's Rhema.
哎，那神的这个 array 嘛，是宝剑呢，就刺了他们的心呢。
God's Rhema is the sword of the spirit that cut their hearts.
哎，所以他们也感觉扎心呢。
Therefore, they were cut to the heart.
那他们就问了，我该怎么办？
And so they asked, What shall we do?
啊，怎么办？主耶稣有没有教他们说，如果有人要来信我，你们为我做见证；如果有人要相信，你们怎么办？
Did the Lord Jesus ever say to his apostles what they should do if someone decides to believe in Jesus?
马太、马可、路加，约翰，你看不出耶稣。下面耶稣讲的这个话，
You cannot find what is written in verse 38 in any of the Gospels.
耶稣没有讲这些话，
The Lord Jesus did not say these words himself.
但是这些话都是耶稣讲过的话。
But all of these, this is what Jesus had spoken of before.
不一样在哪里？
What is the difference?
也就是说。他们所讲的这些话的内容精神是内容意义精神是主耶稣讲了3年，他们哦用2个哦，如果在这里看的话，用3节把它讲出来，3节圣经节把它讲出来。
We can see essentially that they had summarized the 3 years of the teachings that they received from Jesus Christ into these 3 verses.
哦，这个太厉害了。
This is amazing.
你听，你跟的，如果你在读书的话，
If you are studying,
你听了一个大教授哦，这个顶尖的他，你听了他3年的，要跟他活过3年的那个活过3年。
If you were following a certain professor, a very famous one, and you even lived with him,
那他不想了，讲了多少，而且著了多少书啊？
he had made many different books, published many books, and spoke many lectures.
哎，但是你后来呢？你用那个什么，这里3节圣经节的这个话呢，就把它所有的把它讲出来。
But in 3 verses, they could summarize everything that Jesus meant.
所以这就是，那个圣灵的功用嘛。
This is the work of the Holy Spirit.
这个也是使徒教会的开始。
This is also the beginning of the Apostolic Church.
所以这里讲三件事哈。
There are three items.
第一个，
First,
悔改。
Repent.
每个人都悔改。
Everyone needs to repent.
第二个。
Second,
奉耶稣的名受洗，叫你们罪得赦。
be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins.
哎，你这句话把它放到那个什么查询里面，耶稣没讲过这句话。
If you search up this passage, you wouldn't find that Christ said these exact words.
哎，就是说，奉耶稣基督的名受洗，叫你们的罪得赦。
He never said, Every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of
这里很
sins.
重要的，当然，在这里我们不是讲教义啊，讲教义说是奉耶稣基督的名，这个是耶稣不是这样说的吧？
The Lord Jesus Christ did not say, Be baptized in my name.
没有了，没有说奉耶稣基督的名了。
He did not say, Be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ.
哎，没有这样说过。
He did not say this before.
好，叫罪得赦。好，那再领，这是你们哦，你们必领受所赐的圣灵。
And then you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
这是讲当时听众你们哈。
You, meaning those who are listening.
好，那这就使徒时代的三大基础开始了。
the three main foundations of the Apostolic Church began.
从哪里出来的？
And how, where did it come from?
从彼得的口里出来的。
It came from the mouth of Peter.
哎，所以他讲，在靠着圣灵讲出神的话，这就是圣灵的宝剑。
Through the power of the Holy Spirit, he spoke the words of God. This is the sword of the Spirit.
并且这个也是使徒教会的根基。
This is also the foundation of the Apostolic Church.
啊，那接下来从悔改、洗礼、得圣灵。
After repenting, being baptized, and receiving the Holy Spirit,
这就是使徒在当时道同的开始。
this is the succession of the spirit of the truth that started in the Apostolic Church.
当然，接下来使徒又一直在讲话。
After that, the apostles continued to teach.
那使徒的教训，他们被圣灵。就是圣灵进到他们里面讲出来的，就是在当时要执行的。
The words that the Holy Spirit spoke through them were things that they had to do.
我们再回到二章四十二节，
Let's turn back to chapter 2, verse 42.
他们都恒心遵守使徒的教训。
They continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine.
使徒的教训不是让你来听，然后呢，来检讨或是来讨论的。
The apostles' doctrine was not for analysis or for discussion,
是让你来遵守。
but for you to continue steadfastly
这是得救的要道。
in. This is the doctrine of salvation.
那。这个一开始，这个成为这个我们在《使徒行传》16章哈第四节，
Acts chapter 16, verse 4.
就是来我们念一下16章4节，
Let's read Acts 16, verse 4.
他们经过各城，把耶路撒冷使徒和长老所定的。中文是翻条规，其实就是教义 dogma 哈，交给门徒遵守。
Verse 4, as they went through the cities, they delivered to them the decrees or dogma to keep, which were determined by the apostles and elders at Jerusalem.
你查瑞玛就知道，这个字呢就是 dogma，都是 doctrine，就是用我们现在的话来讲，就是教义。
If we look at Rhema, we will know that the word decrees is also doctrine because the original word is dogma, the same word.
其实这个词在当时，不是教会，专用的字。
This word was not a word specific to the church.
这个本来是那个凯撒，就是皇帝用的字。
This is a word that was used by Caesar.
皇帝，若当时的凯撒，如果出全国的公文的话，就是用这个字，就是那个他颁布谕令，或是那个皇上的这个命令。
This word dogma was used to describe the decrees that the emperor would issue.
譬如说那个路加福音第2章第1节哈。
For example, in Luke chapter 2, verse 1,
就是说，当那些日子，该撒就是凯撒那个亚古士都的旨意下来，中文把它翻成旨意，用中国人话来讲就是圣旨啊。
Verse 1, it says, And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus.
这个圣旨一下来哈。
This decree went out.
以古代来讲的话，圣旨开通一定是跪下听。
In those days, if a decree went out, then everyone has to submit.
然后呢，去做。
You had to do it.
如果圣旨开通了，
And if the decree is issued,
哎，那里面写着说，赐你死，那你也要说谢谢啊，你就自杀了，或是。
and the decree says, I grant you death, then you would have to say thank you and perhaps commit suicide.
那后来教会就用这个词来描写，来就是讲这个教会那个使徒跟长老所规定的这个教义。
So, in the Apostolic Church, the word that was used regarding the doctrines of the apostles was the word decrees or dogma.
所以我们再思考一下。
Let's think about this some more.
耶，那个，神是道，
God is the word
道成肉身。
that came into flesh.
耶稣宣道3年，
The Lord Jesus preached for 3 years.
耶稣讲的话进到使徒的头里面。
The words of the Lord Jesus entered into the heads of the apostles.
那个，应许圣灵来了。
The promised Holy Spirit came.
那特别对使徒描述的就是这个保惠师哈，
This was the Holy Spirit was described as a counselor to the
这个
apostles.
保惠师降到他们身上了，
The counselor came upon them.
他们想起耶稣所讲的所有的话来了，
They recalled all of the words of the Lord Jesus.
然后呢，又进入到耶稣话的真理里面。
They also entered into the truth of the Lord Jesus'
耶稣
words.
升天了，
The Lord Jesus ascended.
耶稣所讲的话在世上都不存在了。
The words that were spoken by the Lord Jesus did not continue to exist on the earth.
因为没有笔记啊，
There were no notes.
也没有录音啊，
There was no recording.
在哪里？
Where was it?
都听在使徒的脑里面。
It was all stored up in the brains of the apostles.
所以，那圣经来了，他们都想起来了。这个是我一直想的，这是很大的神迹，这是历史性的神迹啊！
So when the Holy Spirit descended on them, they were able to remember everything that the Lord Jesus said, which I feel like is the greatest miracle in history.
那个，开始宣道了。
They started to evangelize.
使徒讲出来的话就是神的道。
The words that the apostles spoke were the words of God.
然后呢，开始使徒时代。
Then the apostolic period started.
所以道，这个道就是使徒时代的开始。
The word was the beginning of the apostolic period.
当然跟道连接在一起的就是灵啊。就是圣灵哈，应许的圣灵。
Connected to the truth is the Spirit, the promised Spirit.
没有应许的圣灵，
Without the promised Holy Spirit,
这个道出不来啊。
then the word will not come out.
都在摄氏的头里面，并且可能是模糊了，说不定，
Without the promised Holy Spirit, the word of Jesus Christ would just be confined in the brains of the apostles and perhaps become confuddled.
或许他们在听耶稣讲道的时候打瞌睡啊。
Perhaps when the Lord Jesus was preaching the word, they were taking a nap,
或是东张西望。
or they weren't paying attention.
当然，你也可以说他们都很认真听了，都没有关系。
Or they could have been diligently listening.
但是至少这些话，这个声音就进到他们的头脑里面了。
But at the very least, these sounds, they heard it.
好，现在所以使徒时代的开始就是使徒的教训。
Therefore, we can see that the start of the apostolic period was through the teachings of the apostles.
那这个在那个耶路撒冷这个时代就是奠基的时代，就是基础下了基础的时代。
The time that they had at Jerusalem was laying the foundation.
这个基础立了之后,
After this foundation was set,
这就是道统的开始了。
This was the succession of the truth.
你看,这个道统会传到那个撒玛利亚。
This succession came to Samaria.
那这个道统在使徒时代最先开始是那个摄使徒讲出来的。
Initially, the succession of the truth came from the apostles, the 12 apostles.
接下来我们来看那个使徒行传第八章。
Let's turn to Acts chapter 8.
那我们看第四节。
Let's look at verse 4.
这些人呢，他们去传道。
These people went about preaching the word.
那传道当然就是先讲耶稣。
Of course, they were evangelizing regarding the Lord Jesus Christ.
那你一传道讲耶稣，那个神迹一定跟着。When
they preached the Lord Jesus Christ, then miracles definitely followed them.
那我们再来看12节。Let's
look at verse 12.
12节，他们信了腓力所传神国的福音。They
believed Philip as he preached the things concerning the kingdom of God.
还有耶稣基督的名。And
the name of Jesus Christ.
好，那我们看14节。Verse
14.
他们领受了神的道。They
received the word of God.
慢慢的，这些词都出来了。
These phrases are coming out one by one.
所以这个神国的福音啊，神的道，在使徒行传从哪里来？ 最先从哪里来？
Where did these things concerning the kingdom of God and the word of God come from?
最基础的这个部分就是使徒讲出来的。
The fundamental is fundamentally from the teachings of the apostles.
那最先的那个主轴，那个core吧，还是它的中心，就是悔改、洗礼，就是得救之道，还有呢，圣灵。The
core of these teachings is repent, be baptized, and receive the Holy Spirit.
好，那你看第二阶段，这个神的道，就是神国的福音呢，神的道，这道统传过来了。
In phase two, we see how the kingdom, the things concerning the kingdom of God, and the succession of the truth was preached.
这个会继续下去的。And
it will continue to pass on.
那这个道理到了第三阶段也是一样的哈。It
also continued on into phase three.
那个接下来就是那个。
Into Antioch.
我们就在十一章，你可以自己看了，就是也是那个接受福音了。We
can see ourselves in Acts chapter 11, how people received the word of God.
然后呢，接下来保罗所传的一路都是跟这个一致的。What
Peter was preaching this entire time was uniform.
所以这就是所谓的那个道的统序。This
is what we understand as the succession of the truth.
那这个道的统序从使徒一开始就建立了。Which
was established since the apostles.
对，那建立完之后，这就是变成共同的共信之道。
Once it was founded, then it became what is known as the common belief, common faith.
那个保罗也是传这个道。Paul
also preached this word.
那无论是谁哦。
And regardless of who,
如果你一开始是传这个道,
If at the beginning you preach this word,
那你转了一圈,
and you went in a circle,
你有很多的经验,做了很多的事,
meaning that you had a lot of experience and did many things.
那你后来传的跟这个不一样,
but in the end, you end up preaching something different from this that you had preached in the beginning.
无论是谁啊,
regardless of who you are,
就是彼得也好,
whether it be Peter,
或是保罗也好,
or Paul,
或是从天上有一个天使啊, 他说是他是天使来传这个也好,
or an angel saying that he came from heaven, but he preaches something different from this.
唯一的他们的结果是什么呢?
What is the only consequence that they will bear?
这就是保罗所讲的哈。
This is what Paul said.
我们很熟悉的就是加拉太书第1章第6节。
In Galatians chapter 1 verse 6.
一直到第9节。
From verses 6 to 9.
不管你是谁啊,
regardless of who you are,
唯一的结果就是咒诅,
the only you will definitely meet with a curse.
你看第8节的结果是, 就应当被咒诅,
in verse 8 it says let him be accursed.
第9节结束一样, 一定被咒诅,
in verse 9 let him be accursed.
所以 这是很重要的,
this is very important.
那现在对我们真耶稣教会来讲,
so in terms of the True Jesus Church,
我们所传, 我们对这个道统, 现在是什么呢? 什么是使徒时代的道统, 在真耶稣教会的身上呢?
What is the succession of the truth that has been passed down from the apostolic age to the True Jesus Church?
就是我们的十大信仰,
our 10 basic beliefs.
记住, 十大信仰,
remember 10 basic beliefs.
谁攻击, 谁反对十大信仰,
whoever attacks or opposes the 10 basic beliefs,
保罗会说他应当被咒诅,
Paul says let him be accursed.
那让我们一起默祷,
let's bow our heads and pray in silence.